Hi guys, and welcome back to Photography 101 with me, Sapna Khan. Let's get started. So last week we learned about the aperture, shutter speed and ISO that make up the exposure triangle. And we saw how any one of these three settings can have a direct effect on the exposure of our image. So today we will be learning how to take that perfectly exposed image, no matter what aperture, shutter speed or ISO settings we decide to use, in order to show how we can compensate for either that loss of exposure or too much exposure in our image. I did a small still life setup here in the studio. Let's take a look. The aperture at f8 is quite wide and is giving us a somewhat shallow depth of field, as you can see from the blurriness of the books in the background. The shutter speed is set at 1/8 of a second, which is quite slow. It is important to mention here, when your camera is handheld and your shutter speed is lower than about 1/60 of a second, even the slightest shake of your hands cause your image to be blurry. So either mount your camera onto a tripod or balance it on a steady surface. Now, back to the composition. Now let's say I wanted an even shallower depth of field and I decide to widen the aperture by 2 stops, bringing it down to f4. This makes my overall image 2 stops overexposed. So, in order to revert my image to that initial level of exposure, I will need to adjust my shutter speed by 2 stops. So we take it from 1/8 of a second to 1/30 of a second. There you go, we have arrived at the original exposure. Similarly, let's assume that we decide to lower our ISO down 3 stops to 800. We can see that makes our image 3 stops underexposed. So to make up for that loss of exposure, we can make our shutter speed slower by 2 stops. And to overcome that last stop of underexposure, we can widen the aperture to f4. There you go, we're back at our original exposure.
That's it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to hit that like button. See you guys next time.